It's Mike. I've been trying to call your cell for the last 2 hours. It just keeps going to voicemail. Is everything all right? Oh, snap. I was starting to think maybe you were ignoring me. I'm just kidding. What are you still doing at work? It's getting kind of late. Damn, Harp, that sounds rough. Good thing I called to cheer you up. About our trip, did you get a chance to book the rental house? Just really wanted to see you. And Nora. No worries, Harper. I don't want to stress you out. As long as you book it tonight, I think it'll be fine. Hey. I was thinking, since we both live in the city, maybe I could pick you up and ride together. It'd be nice to catch up. You know, save on gas and relive the good old days. Just a little bit of Mike and Sydney time before Nora gets there. Great. I guess I'll let you get back to work then. Wait, one more thing. When you book the rental, please make sure to keep it under $100 a night. Nora and I were talking, and she's been on a pretty tight budget. Things haven't been going very well for her. It'll be just like the old college days. You always had a knack for finding the best spots. Right, of course. Sorry for yapping. I'm just excited, I guess. All right, talk to you later, Harp.
This just in. Reports of a strong snowstorm coming towards Woodbury. Residents are recommended to stay indoors and keep warm during this time. Let's check in with our field reporter. How's the weather out there, Bill?
It's so cold out here.
I'm going to
get
sounds like someone's having a bad day. Maybe you should call.
Shit, why can't you come out here and deal with the snow instead of me? Ooh. I've been working here for 6 years, and I've never been to work somewhere nice.
Listen, Bill, I'm just clearly the better looking. You can worry about where you'll report once you get that rhino.
Rhino? Why would I need rhino? My face is perfectly fine.
You could also use some Botox while you're at it.
You guys are going to hate me. I swear, I'll get on the road as soon as I can. But something last minute popped up. I'm not going to bore you with all of the details. The long and short of it is one of my clients needs a last minute change. Their payments are about the only thing keeping the lights on. I hate to leave so late, but I've got to keep them happy. I'll have this logo done before you know it and be on my way.
Good evening, Vermont. This is your host on WKWB, your hometown station, bringing you the best tunes to warm your hearts on this chilly night. As we embrace the first snowfall of the season, there's nothing like a perfect song to set the mood. So here's a track that'll make you feel right at home. Coming up next, Be Sincere by Neb and Ultimus. Stay warm and stay tuned.
I don't wanna talk about what's wrong or right. Pitch me up on the mic, spitting what I like. I've been reminiscing on friends I'm missing. Maybe I can find them if they're still in my distance. Like, I don't mean shit weird, but come on, man, be sincere. We're gonna be here 100 years, so let's appear. All night, man. Don't fight, man. I'm trying to make something from nothing and get some memories, cause there is plenty of me lurking in the streets. But you're certain that your purpose is surplus to me. Like, you cannot pick up the phone, you cannot even write that. You think this all we're living for, isn't that sad? But if it's where we're headed, I don't wanna recollect it. It's hard for moments, cause it only swimming in direction. So hit me back and I'll send you some love. Don't let it sell it, cause I just wanna be your one. Like real, check me out, I'm the man of the minute. I'm feeling different from some instances that fuck me up. I wanna be the one that saves you, but I don't really blame you. If you wanna be known, then I won't control you.
yourself the deal of a lifetime. Thank you.
flows down the rivers like a mayonnaise water park. So first, we are going to prepare the asparagus. Season these with a lot of salt. Salt is good for the bones. After letting these simmer in the salt bath, we can start making the chocolate. Take a couple cocoa beans. Yes, the cocoa beans need to be blended into the sauce with a little bit of vinegar. Gotta keep that fancy flavor in there. The next thing we prepare is the mayonnaise. We stir fry this in a pan with Irish tofu. I'm not gonna lie, this is gonna taste like shit. But here you are anyway, listening to my cooking instructions. This is the brain of the mayonnaise. We gotta inject it with a little anesthesia to make sure it doesn't revolt against us. It gets very angry once it knows we're trying to cook it. After doing that, we mix all the ingredients together in a tray and place it inside the oven. Okay, and while that's cooking, we can start on the appetizer. Gasoline-soaked ramen. Now this dish is extremely hard to make. A dish only for experienced cooks. It requires a lot of patience and skill. What you will need is gasoline and ramen. This dish really soothes the soul, almost like a cayenne cleanse. We begin by pouring the gasoline into this pot. Make sure not to use whole gasoline since it's really bad for you. Maybe use 1% or half and half. Do not use diesel. So after letting the gasoline come to a boil, we can put in our ramen. I'm using some stuff I found in my grandmama's basement. But you can use whatever kind you like. This ramen will taste fantastic once the gasoline fully soaks into the noodles. It's actually kind of scientific. Bill Nye who? The gasoline molecules merge with the noodle molecules, and they taste very good.
Huh?
70 miles away from Woodbury, and my stinking tire just blew out. It's snowing, and I'm on the side of the road on Highway 11 near Killington. There's a sign by the side of the road. It's hard to see. I think it says Kent Pond. The snow is like half of a deep, and I can't get the lug nuts off the tire. I hate to ask, but can you two come get me?
You need a vacation and want it cheap.
Man,